200 years ago, the aristocracy made Brighton fashionable when the Prince Regent started coming here. A local doctor had recommended the benefits of... The pavilion the Prince Regent had built remains a tourist attraction. There's fun at the end of the palace pier. Shopping's popular too, especially among the antique shops in the old part called the Lanes, and there's plenty going on elsewhere in town. In Brighton or any other British resort, it's still possible to have a cheap holiday. Now, I'm not talking about hotels like the Grand. There, a double room with dinner, bed and breakfast could set you back about £150 a night for two. But what about this? If you know where to look, you can find high standard at low cost. Here at the 21, a night in this four-poster bed will cost £22 each, sharing, of course. Downstairs, the most expensive of the hotel's seven rooms is the garden suite. £52 a night between two. Plenty of hotels would charge double that and not offer you nicer surroundings. All these prices include breakfast. And if you want to eat in the evening, there's a four-course gourmet dinner cooked by one of the two owners. The pre-dinner drinks are served in the basement lounge.
You might know about the 21 and a lot of other hotels like it if you hadn't heard of an organisation called Gestacom. But this Gestacom booklet opens the door to something like 300 places to stay all around Britain. They're all fairly small, they're picked for their comfortable rooms and their reasonable prices, and, like this one, they're all a little bit out of the ordinary.
A few doors away, you could be staying more cheaply in one of the mainstays of the British holiday scene. Guest houses in Brighton charge roughly £12 a night each, about what you'd pay anywhere else at the seaside. What varies is the standard of comfort and cleanliness, food and welcome that you'll get. If friends can't recommend a guest house, there's always a guidebook or the local tourist office's accommodation guide. What if you prefer the extra facilities of a larger hotel? At the Madeira, one of the cheapest on the seafront, a week's half board will cost you about £153 each. But if you're not coming by car, you can get a package holiday by rail. A week here through a tour operator gives you half board, return second class tickets from anywhere in England and Wales, and a taxi from station to hotel for between £179 and £224, depending from where and when you travel. But unless you live a long way from Brighton, it's worth checking that you can't do it cheaper by booking direct with the hotel and arranging your own British Rail Saver returns. If you prefer the alternative of an hotel with entertainment laid on, there's Butlins. Brighton's Ocean Hotel is one of five Butlins hotels around the country. It's not the last word in luxury, but Butlins seems to put the emphasis on activities and amenities rather than accommodation. It's the kind of hotel you can visit at any time of the year and be entertained pretty well around the clock. A sea view double room with bath costs between £103 and £138 a week, and that includes all your entertainment as well as two meals a day. Under fours aren't accepted, but children between 4 and 15 come half price, and if you have two children sharing your room, there's no charge for the second one. The good old redcoats are on hand to look after the kids all day if you can bear to be parted that long. Groups and families might like to think about renting a university flat. The University of Sussex in Brighton is one of a number in Britain that takes in holidaymakers. They rent out student flats when the students have gone home for the summer. And a week's rental of a flat like this, which sleeps six, will cost you from £145 to £190. Don't expect anything but basic furnishings. You get an open-plan kitchen, come dining and living room, a shower room and lavatory, and in a six-person flat, one twin room and four singles. But you also get use of the university's facilities. At Sussex, that means the campus shops, the health centre, the cafe where you can get snacks and salads, the laundrette, students' bookshop, and the newsagent and sweet store. It's like a small village. There's also a sports centre where you can use the squash and badminton courts and the gym. A few miles beyond the university, out in the countryside that surrounds Brighton, you could make an inexpensive stop on a touring holiday here. This is St Mary's Farm, and it's one of over 1,000 farms in Britain which takes in guests for bed and breakfast. Brenda Goff charges £12 a night each, with a reduction if a child shares with you. The price includes a proper cooked breakfast, and if you're around in the evening, you've got use of the sitting room. Comfortable and homely, that sums up St Mary's Farm and many more like it. The first holiday a lot of young people take on their own is to a youth hostel. This one's just outside Brighton in the 18th century Patcham Place house. It's not generally known that youth hostels are also happy to take in families. There's no age limit, and out of season when things are quiet, a family could often have a dormitory to themselves. Normally, however, the dormitories are strictly single sex. Either way, the charges are £6.40 a night for adults and £5.30 for under 16s, breakfast included. And the wardens in charge of the hostel certainly don't skimp. Bacon or sausage and egg and as much toast as anyone can stow away. This hostel also serves an evening meal with three courses for just £2.15. A typical menu would give you Sandra Llewellyn's vegetable soup, then beef pie and roast potatoes and pears and ice cream to finish. All 260 youth hostels in England and Wales are graded, and the most basic, usually in very rural areas, charge even less than Patcham. Next to pitching a tent somewhere, a hostel's one of the cheapest bases you'll find anywhere in the countryside.
And that's all for now. Next week, wish you were here in Australia. I've been all over Down Under to film a special report to celebrate Australia's 200th birthday. Join me in the land of Oz, won't you, next Monday at 7 o'clock. See you then. Bye-bye.